Make your computer easier to use. Windows will read and scan this list automatically. Make your computer easier to use. Windows sign.
Hello. Am I back? Hi. Apparently, I went
Make your computer easier to use. Windows will read and scan this list automatically. Press the space bar to select the highlighted option. Windows sign in window, ease of access button.
Escape, space, fitter, happier, more productive. Well, so what I did by accident was, since I couldn't see anything, I hit a bunch of random buttons. I did control alt delete and I opened ease of access and that happened. So great. But no, it's good. I figured out what the problem was. It's all good now. It's all good now. So we're going to do some Lizard Crate. And sorry about the restart. Technical difficulties and that. So we're done with shitty simulators. But I feel like my computer is a lot easier to use now. So I'm happy. I'm good. And I have a question for everyone here. Is that, tell me, Douglas. Do you let Porkchop come on your dates with you? Lizard Crate is, I think, sent by Alizarin. So one of our viewers. It's been around a while. He sent me a collection of some good games, some weird games, and some not games. And I'm going to start with Secret Habitat. So just a second. Let me get this all set up. And I might not be able to get to all these games today because there's a lot of them. But this one sounds interesting. There will be a black screen for just a moment. I'm going to work on getting that changed as soon as possible. There we go. Fuck. Hang on. And the game just fucking closed. Okay, hang on. You know, a lot of these games that I play, I've never played before. Most of them. So, it's always like I have to navigate menus and hope that there's some kind of options that would make the game easier for me to stream. Anyway, we got some wind sound effects here. So this is, again, this is Secret Habitat, and this is part of the Lizard Crate collection. There's no mouse lock. Now there is. Okay. Let me show you the world. Let me show you some options that can make your computer even easier to use, like an on-screen narrator.
Space. Escape. Hello. Why don't you love me? Windows 10 would like to update.
What's that? You're busy with a school report? Windows 10 would like to update now. Sorry. All unsaved progress will be lost. Would you like to go to Pornhub.com? What is this? What is this music? Friend Support is the name of this piece. I get a deep sense of despair. Mainly from the music, but also from this piece of art. This one's called Pain Promotion. I mean, I don't know much about art, but it kind of just looks like some corruptions.
Same here.
Alien music. Maybe house. Looks like more glitches. Girl week. Girl. You get a whole week to yourself, girl. And this is the art that represents that. List note. Why do I have a feeling this art is randomly generated? Is anyone else getting that feeling that maybe there's not a whole lot of intent behind some of these works? Go idea. Blue sharp. Well, it's not blue. Make luck. Let me see if I can do a little work here. So let me show you the magic of live. Let me show you the magic of live photoshopping. Okay, I take that back. That's probably not going to happen. You know what? Yeah, it can happen. Whoops. I want to be a grown-up with a grown-up sense of humor. And so in order to do that, I'm going to replace that L with an F. And I can't move it. I can't move it. It's too small. Oh, wait. Almost. Yeah, that maybe. Kind of. Hey, I did it, everyone. I did it. As a test of my skill. As a live editor using XSplit. It's not as easy as you think. Right effect. Regular shape. Oh, fuck. Would you like some making luck? Apology outline. That's me right now, actually. This art really represents how I feel for this whole shenanigans. Really, it was a stupid bit, and I didn't like it, and I apologize to all of you. I can do better. Let me show you how. For example, with school, my estimate. So yeah, you weren't kidding when you said that this was really fucking weird. This is really not anything. This isn't a game so much as it is. I mean, that could almost be something. There's like almost a human shape in there. Boat birth. What? It's just the name. I think this is just random. This was like generated randomly. And that looks cool. Including the names. You guys want to see how boats are born?
Well, let me explain. Let me take you aboard my yacht, Douglas, and I'll show you how boats are born.
Next pipe. Serious iron. Let me pump some serious iron. I'll show you how I pump and calm iron.
get to the cut credit.
I mean, part of me likes this, and part of me wants to like it more. tongue picture. Apparently, according to Alizarin, this whole game is just randomly generated
angry thunder.
Gold substance. Kettle dark. View laugh. Kinda looks like... Kinda looks like the fucking end of Chrono Trigger a little bit. Eh, maybe not. Paint, aim it! I'm okay. You loose. You know, joking aside, there is something exceedingly weird and kind of a little tiny bit creepy. Not really creepy, but just unsettling slightly about a computer generating random art, including random music, random names. Like, this is art to a computer. We're on the cusp of an AI revolution. We're on the cusp of, like, computers having some form of intelligence. Loudboat. And, yeah, like, this is what a computer can create for art. Seat plane. Among insect. Let me take you to the deep spoop of the computer web and try to turn this into something worthwhile. Okay, this building's gonna be good, I know it. This is gonna be the best building. There's nothing in here. So, even the world itself is randomly generated. There doesn't seem to be any kind of finite... So, I was thinking... Chance potato. I was thinking that someone took a bunch of randomly generated things and threw them in a game and designed the buildings around them and put the music that they liked in there. I'm now beginning to think that this whole fucking thing, like, even the buildings and the art inside of them, is completely random. Knowledge drink. Chemical branch. Just two of the same color. And then this one is church spade. Bath bite. Glove swim. I don't know why, but the word glove, maybe because of Spinal Tap, but the word glove always has some weird fucking kind of perverted connotations with me now. Machine replace. Guys, what is the machine going to replace? Also, does that kind of look like a face screaming in sheer agony? Sales guy. Escape. Tall fall. Is that humanity's tall fall? Bright ant. Pretty sure that if I keep walking in a direction, it's just gonna keep generating new buildings with random shit. Yep. Oh, wait, no. No, there's an edge. There's a limit. It seems like there's a limit. Goat apology. The name of that is pretty great. Scale measure. I got a few more. Plow female. I was looking for a joke in the art. There's not a long elastic. What the fuck? This room is disgusting. Noise light. Reminder fact. Sky reel. Respect screw. Like I said, this place is fucking perverted. Respect the screw. Swing picture. Space base. I kind of appreciate this art a lot more knowing it's completely randomly generated. Leave here. Okay. Say who? No, but... Boat clean. There's some kind of, like, fucking horror story unfolding here. That music went a little bit too well with leave here. Oh, we're back in perverted building. Respect screw. Enter the same building twice. That's like... There's a lot of buildings. I keep entering the same ones. Power look. Problem July. It's happening this July, everyone. The AI is taking over. There's gonna be some kind of bridge that's going to collapse because of thunder. It'll look like thunder, but it'll really be the machines. Girl food? Violent thread. Yes, there is a violent thread. What the fuck is happening? Pocket luck. Plant long. Engine sound. Delete want. It wants to delete us. Event inquiry. Yes, I am curious. Debt complete. Oh, fuck this. Fuck this. This game is trying to give us a fucking message. Woodshock. I think it's time for me to return to the sea. It's so fun to just disregard. Stop, same, or even. It's so fun to just disregard the irrelevant ones and just look for the ones that are part of the story. Heart full. He after. You could probably fit all of this into some kind of, like, story about AI taking over and killing all the humans. See? Broken happened.
Dear God.
It's a spooky! So we do the mash.
The bent wax mash.
Flower trick.
I'm gonna go up here, and then I'm gonna go into the ocean. Option stopped. Reach cheap. Argument any. Waste help. Meat while. Talking about an argument, there's a fight, and then we're meat. While the angle is broken. Butter error. The product. And this is like, yeah, this is a song name generator room. I gotta remember some of these if I ever decide to make a Mars Volta-esque song. He everything. So there's one AI that leads. Also, that looks like a dog. Third cup. Shock early. This is amazing, but also really incredibly dumb. It's both of those things at the same time. Combine comfort. It's gonna use a combine harvester. And harvest our organs into the meat butter. Into a cup. Two meat, one cup. I'm out. Leaving. Drop me in the ocean. Never to return. It's gonna be like the Combine from Half-Life 2. That was Secret Habitat, and that was really fucking weird. Next is Planetarium. I should probably change the name of this from trash to weird or something like that. Still a lot of people here for a fucking 2 a.m. stream. Jesus. Weird. Weird dreams. I have two games for Sundays usually. Weird dreams and trash. Okay, there's a whole set of instructions that comes with this. The fields are home to thick winged bugs. And this is Synxoid Omicron. Let's go to Planet S. Grongon ETA, the deep lakes are home to small fish. Oh, fuck. It says Kappa. This music is really good. I like this a lot. It's gonna lower it slightly. I think this is just... Let's go to Planet Dildo. I think this just, like, randomly generates planets. Felot. What does this have to do with dildos? Yep, the chat is totally a mess now because of that Kappa. At the right temperature, the planet is home to some form of life. So this slider changes the temperature. Oh wow, look at that. What the hell just happened? A little thing appeared. And then disappeared. There's over 150 secret planets to find. This is a planet generator, not a game. Type in a name and press enter to visit. Okay, so planet Vinesauce then. Vinesauk. Good enough. Welcome to Planet Vinesauk. There's no life here. If I could just get the right temperature, maybe we could create some life. No. The grasslands are inhabited by short, dull, multicolored, four-legged reptiles. Artists, there's something for you to draw. One of them seems to be talking to the others. Oh, they're sentient. And now they're dead because I just flooded the entire planet. That just takes you to a random planet. Let's try, Planet Escape. Copini. I don't know what the, it's not really taking you to planet named Escape. It just takes you to someplace, like, kind of random. The cloud layer is full of clans of enormous, unusually muscular winged folk. What do you mean, unusually muscular winged folk? That's just the seed, not the planet. Okay, that's just- it's just a seed. So it's not actually the name of the planet, right? Well. Here on planet Bird Person, we are very muscular. Unusually so. We fly amongst the clouds.
Eart.
Tapamar, if you're looking for Earth, you'll have to try harder than that. What is beyond all numbers? Infinity. Infinitus. Very good. And what is outside of space? Oh, that's cool as fuck. What's outside of space? Nothing. There really is nothing here. void. There's no more clues. Outside of space-time? Well done. Now go to the end. Planet Kronos. Because time... the end of time. I thought maybe there was a Chrono Trigger reference somewhere in there. Armageddon. Not quite, but very close. The end. Good. So then, what is Earth to the human race? Home? It's, Earth is, world. No. It is, everything. No. Life. The seas are home to incredibly fierce bacteria. That's not part of it. Let's try mother? No, it didn't work. Origin? Here it is. It was Origin, the birthplace of the human race, before they fled to Sardonia and beyond. Also the first known location of the terrifying... Is that Bob? I think I see Bob. Hi, Bob! Now it's... nothing. This is the temperature map, by the way. Mars. For 150 years, humans had their eyes on Mars, but it always proved too inhospitable. Eventually, they looked further around. Further abroad. Sorry, this game only produces habitable planets, not gas giants. Oh. Bob. Man, that Bob guy, right? Everyone loves him! He's just so swell, gosh! I wish I was as cool as Bob! Sardonia. A desolate wasteland of deserts and acrid swamps. Compared to old Earth, but a welcomed respite for the destitute remains of the human race. Some years after humans arrived, sentient ships were sent off from Sardonia to New Earth, Equitos, home and New Eden. Presently, no life remains. So, Equitos, huh? It's fucking like Battlestar Galactica. Equitos, Omicron. Near the South Pole is a sprawling city with high-density farms, large transport networks, and a spaceport. But everyone seems to have left in a hurry. Presently, no life remains. Tatooine. Oh. The water is inhabited by a dwindling number of small legless creatures. Cthulhu? No. Just taking suggestions from the chat now. New Eden, home to a human settlement for 200 years. New Eden gave its occupants a life on solid ground again, free from pursuit for generations. The population grew, production and technology returned, and surpassed what it had been before the darkness came to old Earth. Humanity once again found peace, and with it, complacency. Then, as it had to Sardonia and all the rest, the darkness came again. As the darkness closed in on New Eden, a single settlement ship survived its launch and set a course for exile. Presently, no life remains. And the human race did some stupid shit, huh? Exile. After a timeless period drifting through space, so nearly destroyed in the escape from New Eden, the settlement ship eventually landed on this small, harsh planet. The air is thin, the flora is bitter, and the taste of almond and the fauna is deadly and inedible, but it's home. A new settlement ship is still under construction, and a comprehensive list of potential planets has been compiled and is available for viewing in the planetarium. The terrible darkness appears to have stopped following, at least for now. That's where they're at now. And now it's too hot for them to live there. Oh no, they still live. Darkness. Carved 100 meters into the ground and spanning 1,000 kilometers, what appears to be a star chart. The holes corresponding to Earth, Ranor, Titania, and 3 other planets are filled with some sort of liquid. There are signs of life in the past here, but presently no life remains. Ranor, an advanced civilization once lived here, a lush and beautiful metropolis in the past. Present-day Ranor is simply empty. So cold. Vulcan. Yeah. Exfara Prime. Deep underground, the planet is inhabited by some fast, pink, six-legged things they look to be playing. I was hoping to find Klingons. Nope, CB's doesn't work. Dune. Arrakis. The deep sands are home to enormous, incredibly strong worms, known locally as Great Makers, and worshipped as gods, the only known source of the spice, melange. This is kind of cool. Look, Mobius! Titania. All the trees are dead husks, but up in the canopies there is still occasional treehouse. 100 meters or more above the now dry, barren floor, no life remains. Someone said type dick butt. I'm gonna regret this. Nope. Nothing. It doesn't look like there's a Metroid reference in this game, sadly. Corneria. Nope. The metal wreckage of the settlement ship is the only sign that humans ever touched this planet. Presently, no life remains. Hyrule. Nope. Halo. Water's home clans of differently sized winged sharks. One of them seems to be different to the rest. The deep lakes are populated with a dwindling numbers of omnivorous black six-legged creatures. Popstar? Nope. Alderaan? Alderaan is not in this, but it wouldn't be here if it was, right? Mercury. Starman. Or here we go, Bowie. No, I typed it A-L-D-E-R-A-A-N. Alderaan. See? I typed it both ways. Ziggy. Now Ziggy played guitar. SR-388. The deep lakes are home to omnivorous green scaly lampreys. Some of them seem to be waving at us. Oh god. Sentient lampreys. Oh, look at this. Rainbow. Red, yellow, purple, blue, green, orange. That's cool. Isn't Neptune... Oh, that's not gonna work. Try Zelda. Oh, look, it's hey, listen! The Red Vox Planet. Why not? Nothing is on this planet. The desolate, porous rock is full of vibrant, pale, six-legged insects. Super Mario World. The castles are home to large, vicious, turtle-like creatures. So many castles. So few princesses. I'm not really sure what that button does. Oh, it launches rockets. From the planet. Doesn't really do anything, just lags the game, but it's still pretty cool to look at. Pluto, sorry, this is a planetarium, not a planetarium. Fuck that. That's such bullshit. Star Char. No. Someone wants me to type in vagina. I don't know why I'm complying. Wow, you're so mature. The name of the planet is Really. God damn it. Alright, so penis. Really? Wow, you're so mature. What do you know? Planet. Alright. Fuck. Really? Wow, you're so mature. Cock. Really? Oh, jeez. Jeez, that's pretty rude! Cunt. Jeez, that's pretty rude! Of course. Now everyone's... Hololia. I typed anus. and I got whole Hololia. I think that's about it. Here, I'll try Sonic. Oh god, it's here! Mobius! Planet is home to a remarkable population of incredibly fast blue hedgehogs. Fuck's sake. Guy Fieri. Planet Flavortown. Nope. Why is this so entertaining? This shouldn't be this entertaining. They're leaving exile. Alright. Okay, I've had enough of that. That was really good. I don't know why I like that so much, but that was really cool. Alright, I'm sure there was a lot of cool secrets that we missed, but I think we're good. Speaking of shitty simulators, this isn't necessarily a shitty simulator, but the name of this is, okay, the most confusing name of all time. A Lifetime of Realistic Simulations. Simulation of Life Simulation. That's the name of the game. Whatever that means. Planetarium was the name of the previous game. A Planetarium dash a Planet Simulator. I'm positive I've heard this music somewhere on like a free music, royalty-free music website. I've probably... have not used it, but I've downloaded it. Okay, this game does not window well, so just a moment. You know, let me give you an example of what this music is. Hang on. Kevin MacLeod did this song? Of course he did. That dude does so much royalty-free music. Hi! Welcome to my YouTube channel! Today, I'll teach you about cooking. Tomorrow, I'm gonna teach you about chopping wood. I hope you enjoy! Here's some candy that I put on a piece of paper. Do you like macaroni bracelets? Name, I can't actually choose my own name, so I'm gonna random Ricky Peterson. That's just, I closed my eyes and I just hoped for the best.
All right, listen up now. Before we send you out into the world, you're going to have to make some important decisions. You see, the choices you're about to make will affect your character's traits, strengths, and weaknesses in game. You know this is about your future, right? You should get started right away.
I'm not going back to the carpet store.
You'll be ready to face whatever's out there, for sure.
My combat specialization mastery is gonna be slap.
How can you slap?
Oh, this one's important.
Choose your career. Is there a way I can go to a carpet store? I'm gonna be a firefighter.
I think you made the right choice.
Choose your means of transportation.
You're doing great.
Choose your housing type. I'm gonna go for a modern
Nicely
villa.
Nicely done.
Oh, massive.
Okay, next one.
Absolutely massive. Choose your companion. I'm allergic to cats.
Yes.
Why did he? That was a weird noise. Douglas? Did you bring your dog, Douglas? Choose your poison. It used to be that. Now it's this once maybe every 2 or 3 weeks. But this happens almost every day, so coffee it is.
Are you feeling all right?
Choose the amount of profit insurance companies make. Fire damage, considering I'm a fucking fire. I can't actually unclick. Whoops.
You seem to be turning a bit pale.
Choose what? 72.000 master. What is it supposed to be, money or to decorate your toilet with? This one's a little earthy, you know, a little diapery.
I don't know how to tell you this, but you're almost dead.
What? Holy shit, this guy just took Ricky off the grid! After a long battle with ignorance at your computer, your unawareness, aged 72, beloved enemy of the life you were hoping to find will not be missed at all. Funeral will be at Game Jolts, 7th of February 2016, 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Family flowers only. Garbage. Let me just try a few different choices and see what happens. That was it. Like, that was apparently the whole game. Or maybe there was more and I just clicked out of it, but we'll see. I mean, after all, it is Life Simulator, so it stands to reason that you would die at the end of it. I'm not complaining. I feel like I got my money's worth. Granted, I didn't pay for it, but... you know, it's a free game, you get your money's worth. Lifetime. How big is this game's files? I don't know, actually. Ran it from a zip. I'll look after this. Max Kenobi? Sure.
All right, listen up now. Before we send you out into the world, you're going to have to make some important decisions. You see, the choices you're about to make will affect your character's traits, strengths, and weaknesses in-game. You know this is about your future, right? You should get started right away. Once you're done with these, you'll be ready to face whatever's out there for sure.
Punch.
Oh, this one's important.
Alright, my shuffle, I'm gonna go not employed.
Right choice.
Right, yes! Good! A means of transportation is going to be a walking.
You're doing great. Nicely done. Okay, next one.
Modest. Live modestly. I'm not gonna get the giant TV.
Oh, yes.
I have a bad pussy to live with.
Are you feeling all right? You seem to be turning a bit pale.
I think it's all nonsense.
I don't know how to tell you this, but yeah, it's all dead.
It's all the same shit. But the future refused to change. Do I want to play some of the weird games now? Welcome to the Spiders, or as subtitled by Alizarin, Vinny's Closet Simulator. You mean the Spider Room, which isn't necessarily a closet. It was more of a storage room. But that's fine. That's fine. You can call it a closet. Whoa. What's wrong? And people in chat are freaking out. You don't like spiders? They're great. Have you seen how cute they are? Sometimes they're a little fuzzy, right? You know, burrow in the space between your eyeball. Right? Right? Enter the dungeon. So I'm an away team member, and I'm heading to different planets to kill spiders. That's my job. That is my job. I am a red shirt on the crew of the Enterprise that's sent basically to kill spiders, and that's it. Except I don't actually wear a red shirt. I think it's randomly generated. Look how zoomed in this is. Look at this resolution. I can't see a fucking thing. I mean, hey, if it's someone's first game, then I think it's pretty cool. Oh, it's for a 64x64 resolution game jam. Okay. Oh, that was part of the good games. Then there's Royals, which is in fact not a song. Was it Lord?
Yeah.
Is that who it was? It was Lord that did the song called Royals?
Yeah. Oh, I'm Lord.
That's like the worst thing that could have happened to her, was having South Park parody her for an entire season. Because now I don't think about Lord's music when I think of Lord. I think, yeah. That's it. I'm sure she's a very talented young lady and she has great music, but I don't know. Because I just think to myself, yeah. Oh, that's it. Oh, okay. Got, okay. Optimistic Peasant Simulator, let's go. Humble peasant, what is your quest in life? I want to become the king. A noble goal for a dirty serf. You're 12th year, you've outgrown your life as a humble farmer. You decide to leave your farm and pursue your quest. Unclaimed desert. unclaimed grasslands. Let's plow. You spend the year tending the field. You begin your 13th year. You've turned the empty field into an empty farm. The current ruler of this land, Royal Sunday, has a castle southwest of here. You spend the time rallying the occupants of the farm. You begin your 14th year. You manage to convince the occupants of the farm to follow you around. I gain one person, but minus one home. I'm going to build nothing because I need wood. Chop. Send follower. Your follower spends the year tearing down the forest. Hunt. You spend the year living wild and free. You begin your 15th year. Your follower has cleared the forest. Hunting has improved your physique considerably. What is this music shit? Recruit music? Okay, let's chop down some more forest. Independent house. Ransack. I'm gonna spend a year ransacking a house. You spend the year tearing down the independent house. Your follower has cleared the forest, and you scavenge some goods from the destroyed house. Royal Sunday is sending some soldiers to investigate the violence. Oh shit. It would take 60 wood to build a castle. I'd best get the fuck out of here. I'm gonna build a tavern. And while I'm doing that, I guess I'll chop down some more fucking trees. Get some kettlebells and fucking alpha brain. You begin your 17th year, your follower has built a tavern and moved into it. Royal Sunday did not give you permission to grow your empire. Royal Sunday is a fucking royal cunt. Sunday and foot soldiers. Uh-oh. I'm gonna try to ambush. 15% chance. You managed to dispose of the soldiers. No shit. It took a year to dispose of the soldiers, but I did it. Rally from my tavern. I spent some time rallying the occupants. I've gained one person, but I lost the tavern. Oh, that sucks. Oh, so you can't. If you rally, you actually lose a person. Okay. So let's just let's get some chop. percent to recruit. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna try to recruit. Spend the year playing music and spinning stories for the patrons. Followers clear the forest. Your terrible taste in music has gotten you into trouble. That sounds like my real life. Independent market. Sell materials. Okay, what do I gain from that? I didn't do that right. Your father got a terrible deal for your materials. I got two coins. I should have sent the other follower to do that. Independent house. I'm gonna ransack that shit. Follower will ransack. He's good. He knows what's up. And the independent tavern. Ransack chance is very low. Hunt. Alright. Returns with some goods. Royal Sunday is sending soldiers. Okay, Royal Sunday again. But I am losing health, so I'm gonna have to, like, rest or something. Let me. I probably need some coinage. I don't have good coinage. There are no good coinage around. Unexplored caves. Let's spelunk. Send a follower to spelunk in the cave. Oops, I made a mistake again. Followers rescued some cave dwellers from the darkness. Wow, that's a lot. It's hard to manage many new followers. Your wealth dwindles. Okay, I'm gonna have the meditate in a mountain. Send follower. He's going to meditate for a year. Gonna need some health soon. This is actually kind of cool. Independent farmland. Gonna work. Send follower. Grow some crops. Chop. Send follower. And, I guess soon I'm gonna wanna rest. Sunday in garrison. Take over. Follower has disposed of the foot soldiers. Returned from their mountain pilgrimage that did nothing for me. Explored caves. They found money in the caves, so that's good. The follower returns and sell your followers crops for a small sum. More wood. You've cleared the forest. Hard to manage. Oh, my wealth dwindles, but now I have enough to restore some health. Except I'm too fucking far away. Oh, thank you, Fruitgish. Independent mine shaft. Send my follower to ransack that shit. I can rest. I don't know if that restores health, but there was an inn that had an option. I guess I'll try it. Actually didn't expect to be playing this long. I could build a mine. Spend the year carving out the rich mountain. Uh-oh. He sent the fuzz after me for ransacking. Oh god. There's now three soldiers. Oh, fuck. Well, let's hope my followers don't suck at this. Befriending the occupants of the farm. And I'm going to rest. Leisurely year bumming around the inn. It didn't help. Uh-oh. Oh, fuck, I lost 3 followers. I feel well rested, so I did get a little bit of health, but I'm still, like, not very healthy. This isn't going to end well. I'm going to spend some time relaxing. Convert purchase. Just convert. Now I'm going to rest over here. Oh wait, you know what? No. I'm going to rest over here for free in the grasslands for a full year, commuting with the wilderness. Okay, forest. Follower now runs a mineshaft for you. You slept on a lot of rocks, but you feel rejuvenated. Okay, fair enough. Mineshaft, work. Send follower to work in the mineshaft, which is something I should have been doing before. It kind of sucks that you can't move around a whole lot. Like, you have to just kind of... you know... build where you can. I can build a castle soon. I'm gonna do that as soon as I can. Work. Send follower to work. Grow some crops. Let's see what's next. I guess we could, build a mine. Or, there's no more wood left. Explored caves. These are all explored caves already. I'll just rest again. Not quite good enough for a castle. Work, send follower. Hunt, send follower. Hunt, no. Chop, follower. And meditate somewhere on a fucking mountain. I only have 3 people. I had like fucking 6 or 7 people earlier. They're dead now. I feel like such a piece of shit. I let them die. I've gained the power of music by meditating. Chop. We're close. So I'm just gonna build a castle soon. And this is- I probably am going to fuck this up somehow, but this is pretty cool. I'm gonna try to convert them. Well... enlist. Send a follower. There's a very small percentage that I'll be able to do that, but I'm gonna try to convert for 25% chance. Your follower was not ready to join the army. They do not return. Fuck. They refuse. Oh, god damn it. I lost 2 health. Oh, fuck. Not good. Unclaimed desert. I need to get to where there's some forest so I can chop down some trees and build a castle. I'm gonna rest here. I lost music, somehow. Send follower. What happens when you send a follower to rest? Oh, you can't do that, okay. Sunday in Woodlands. Oh, fuck this Lord Sunday. Such an asshole. Oh, I only have 2 followers, actually, so. Okay, well, I guess I can build a castle now. Spends the year building a castle. One guy is spending a whole year. My goal was to become a king. And so... mission accomplished, really. I'm gonna drink at my tavern. You spend the year in a drunken stupor. Your followers built a castle and moved in. Royal Sunday did not give you permission to grow your empire plus 20. Many stories to tell from your drunk- Oh my god! Oh my fucking god. What, my castle? I can't even get in it! And like Jesus, at the age of 33, my character dies. Hey, I have a few bucks. You've been ambushed. Uh-oh, you've died at 34. Oh, I didn't even get the chance to die at 33. A lowly peasant will be forgotten. I did... Hey, but I did end up building a castle, so that's pretty cool. I'm gonna exile myself through the desert. You are so thirsty. What the fuck is the point of exiling yourself? I'm just gonna ransack this blacksmith and hope for the best. Queen Todd. Nah, fucking, this blacksmith can eat a dick. I'm telling you, this is mine. Yeah, I did it. It's mine now. Success. Toddy and Manor, ransack. Oh, your health has run out. You've died at 22. Well, I didn't get that much further than I did before. So, anyway, that was pretty cool. I could actually see myself playing that a little bit more. But that was pretty good. I have some more weird games for you from the Lizard Crate. Here's a game called Memory of a Broken Dimension. Oh, and again, the name of that game was Royals. Okay, so yeah, there's still a bunch more stuff in this Lizard Crate. I'm not going to be able to get to all this today. Reverb. Okay. Volume is lowered. You have to Google how to start the game properly. Thank you.
Some...
When people tell me that they don't know what I do, and they're like, hey, can you hack a computer for me? Ah, you gonna hack my phone? Because they think I'm good with computers. This is what they think I do. Fuck I'm doing. I just know that there's a few commands that are in this text file, and they're helping me out. Oh God! I'm gonna get arrested. Welcome to Hacker World, when you can actually see the code like Neo. I actually want to watch The Matrix again sometime soon. It's been so long since I've seen that movie. I wonder how funny it'll be now that it's like 17 years later. Like how much stuff that seemed so cool back then is gonna seem so very quaint in 2016. Hey, guess what? I have no idea what's going on. So it kind of becomes solid. I don't know. I mean, I'm hearing weird things and seeing things happen at certain spots. Okay, like right there. Okay. Hack the planet, man! The bitrate must be having a shit right now. See, like, stations, like, certain things happens. There's, like, a line that if I go to it, something different happens. And then I walk into that wall, and then it takes me to a different area. This place. That takes me to a different area. The 56K is booting up. We're gonna be on AOL very soon. Lines indicate where if you look at a certain place, you can solidify an object. Man, I'm sorry, I'm just not getting this. Like, I kinda understand what I'm supposed to do. But I'm also clicking when I get to these objects and nothing is happening and it's giving me like a semi-seizure. Did I see this a while ago? I don't even remember. Isn't the white line my own path? That's just me. That's where I am. I mean, the name of the game is, what the hell's the name of the game again? There's the line that traces your path, and there are the vehicle line stations you noticed, right, so... Am I supposed to just walk from line to line? Until something happens. Memory of a Broken Dimension is the name of this game. So they make noises when I touch them, and then nothing happens. Perspective thing. Look at the glitched object and move around until you line them up to make a solid object. But you can't move back too far, because then... Oh, I see what you mean. I mean, it's not implicit that this is what you have to do, but I kind of understand it now, so you have to... All the broken objects. Need to be kind of like lined up so it creates a solid object. Just stand at the right spot of the room. I don't want to give up on this just yet. I have more games, but I do want to check this out for another minute. I mean, this still isn't quite working. Oh God, it hurts. It really does hurt to look at. Those line stations have lines at the top to point where you need to look to click an object. It's crazy confusing, but yeah, okay. Yeah, I'd say confusing is definitely one way to put it. I did it. Fucking Christ. Now it fucking makes sense. Yeah, you just have to follow where the lines are pointing, which... God damn it. Still not sure how much I like this, but it's... I get it now, and it's an interesting concept. I mean, visually, it looks like diarrhea, and I get that that's the look. It's going for that. It's creepy, it's weird, it's cool, I get it, but it really is not a fun game to look at. I'm sorry. I know it was designed probably not to be. If so, mission fucking accomplished. That one up. So it's a platformer. You know, that's the part that confused me. I didn't realize it was a fucking platformer. It took me a little while to even understand what kind of game it was. But yeah, you have to... a lot of trial and error. I'm not sure what this is all leading up to. Which, you know, I'm assuming I'm gonna have to really play the game, try to understand it. If this is your... Okay, if this is your cup of tea, then I say check it out yourself. Not crazy about it. So I'm looking at the things. But now it's not putting them together. I'm sorry, I've had enough. I tried for a little bit. I did figure out the concept, but I can't do this. Again, memory of a broken dimension. If you are interested in playing more of that and trying to figure out what the hell that is, then go for it. But I don't think I have the patience for it. It is a cool idea, though. If you like that game and I just shit on it, I apologize. I really don't mean to not like the things you don't like, or vice versa, rather. But, you know, that's just how it goes. This next game... is called, Joy Exhibition. Okay, hang on a sec. Let me turn the- this- okay, this looks weird. And this also looks like a game I played a little bit earlier, or at least the intro does. So this is Joy Exhibition, and this is a game where you find joy in exhibiting nudity for aliens. Oh. Remember this? Looks like the same person made a different game. Paintbrush.
I'm painting. I like how even though I'm the one doing the painting, I have like very little control. Like things just kind of happen in their own way. You don't really have a whole lot of control over it. I can't shoot them. I can only shoot in this direction. Anyway, this is going to be my masterpiece. I need a sun. I'm trying to make a landscape. It's not really working out, is it? I don't really have any ability to do anything that looks like a frame of reference. Like, this game deliberately takes away the ability for you to paint based on a frame of reference. It wants you to do something exceedingly strange and foreign, and that's kind of cool. But at the same time, man, I can't really create anything. Okay, that's something. And that just kind of crapped on. Oh, those could be trees. Some happy little trees. All right, get those happy little trees in the bottom left there. It's a forest. What if it's a great big old lush alien forest, huh? Detail, a little shading, right? Underneath the sky, the alien sky. What's that? Maybe that's a dick. Big old dick. Just shot something at you. Right? Right at you, right there. Oh, that's beautiful. Splat, splat.
Art. Job's done.
Now, how do I get my art in the gallery? How do I get that? I don't actually know how to... Oh, there it is already. Oh, I see now. When you enter from a specific spot, that's cool. Oh, that's really cool, actually. I'm trying to make a vine shroom. Unwieldy. Very unwieldy. Here, this looks like vine sauce colors. Never mind. Okay, there we go. Vine sauce colors. Don't really have a whole lot of control over this. You just get randomly generated paintbrushes. That is definitely not helping me make a vine shroom. Some happy little circles. It can be whatever you want them to be. They don't necessarily have to be a vine shroom. Maybe those are tentacles. Maybe those are parasites growing out of an ant's head. Maybe this is May's gun from Overwatch. It doesn't matter, really. It could be whatever you want it to be.
I really, 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 really cannot make a vine shroom.
Maybe it's a happy little centipede on the bottom there, huh?
Alright, the way that expands kind of looks a little bit shady. That's how I'll describe that, shady. Hey, it's art, and it's done.
How do I process said art? Actually, it's not. Whoops. I just damaged my art. Ah, fuck. It's on the outside. We're in a spaceship? Yeah, we're in a spaceship. Put the gun away. That's how you do it? Oh. Oh, there it is. It's garbage. But what can you do? Make one more. One more. It's actually kind of fun, though. There is something very relaxing about this. I gotta say, this is a good game to... Maybe if you live in, say, California, you know, go to a legal dispensary and get some of the sticky icky. Homegrown legally, of course. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, bro? Put on some music, maybe that new Radiohead album that I still haven't listened to, and just draw. I could see something being very, very peaceful and cathartic about this. And having to limit yourself to just, like, colors and shapes and not specifically frames of reference. I mean, some might call this pretentious. And I would understand it. But at the same time, I just like shit like this. Even if it's only fun for 10 minutes, I kind of like to just see people make cool stuff like this. It's also really fun to watch the colors, like, kind of just live, and just the brushes do their own thing. Just have an infinite supply of different types of painting tools. Oh, that looks like spider legs. Spider legs and speed Luigi tongues. Now it's just a big fucking mess. For a minute, I had something that looked alright, and now it's crap. I call this early 90s cup aesthetic. I call this Saved by the Bell High School aesthetic. You can kind of test it on the ceiling a little bit before you go and possibly ruin your painting with it. I want to get one more cool. Oh, that one kind of replaced some of the cool shit. Oh, that's interesting. It's like some kind of alien flora and fauna, you know? Or condoms. Just colored condoms. Back to square one. Pretty much whatever I had that could be considered art is now gone. Like, I had some semblance of an idea of what was happening, now it's just green. Call this Memories of Pretzel. Oh, there you go. There's my gallery so far. These fellas love it. That's so cool. And you can save your artwork too. Graphical quality, good. I wasn't even on the best quality. Yo, hang on a second. This game has better graphics. Maybe it just means those dudes. I don't think the actual paint is gonna be better. Here we go, Speed Luigi painting. This is gonna be just totally random. Just stream of consciousness, random guns. Really quick, last painting. Let's see how it looks without any conscious effort or thought put into it. Well, that just ruined the whole thing. This gun just fucking grew everywhere. And whatever I had that was looking kind of cool, like an alien forest, just got replaced with that gun. I like this one. This one's cool. Kind of reminds me of like bacteria in like a magnifier. Like some sort of like electron microscope, maybe. That looks so cool. The screen is stuck on the settings page. Oh, fuck. Sorry, I don't know how that happened. Sorry about that, guys. You missed some good shit, too. I apologize. I was like, kind of busy painting. I didn't even realize. Sorry. I was gonna just... Really, it was all just random shit. It looked kind of cool for a bit. Anyway, how cool does that look? Almost. Really not sure what I'm doing down there, but kind of feels like there needed to be something down there. I don't really like the bottom left, but the rest of it I like. I like overthought the art. This was cool. This really though, I really like this. This is one of my favorites of the night. And again, this is called Joy Exhibition. So if you're interested in playing this, you're an artist, you want to just do some cool shit, fuck around with like stream of consciousness drawings, be pretentious like me, then this is the game for you. I actually find it kind of difficult to stop. This one, look at this, this is my favorite one. And then the closer you get to, it does some other cool shit. So you can get like real close. It's like an ocean. I promise this is my last one. And one final color. Let's see what this is. I don't know why I have this, like, strong urge to put things in the bottom left corner. Viney on the bottom. That's a cool sky color too up top. Ruined. No, it's in, they're in the foreground, guys. They're like vines. Like it's a giant vine planet where the vines overgrow everything and they're in the foreground. And then over here is like the ocean, and then there's the sky with the alien stuff happening. See, now everyone's saying saved. Okay, I saved my artwork. This was, that was really cool. I really enjoyed that. Maybe I'll paint again for you guys someday. if people are interested, I wouldn't mind doing another short stream of that. 30 minutes. Just fucking around. Just total stream of consciousness, color art. So that was Joy Exhibition. And I guess we'll do one more. Let's see. Purgatelli. So it says loud. So this is gonna be loud. There's no way it couldn't be loud. If the note attached says loud. I'm just gonna keep that down. Purgatelli by the Lonely Troll. WSD move, click select. And M is map. Low res. Oh my god, this is so cool. What is it about low res games like this that are so fucking creepy? Like, I know some people have, like, reasons why they don't like low-res stuff like this. Because lazy or, you know, aesthetic or whatever. But I think there's something really... Like, low-res just lets your mind fill in the blanks. Is this? Wow. Okay, now this really doesn't seem to have a whole lot of rhyme or reason to it. More randomly generated stuff? Aliens watching TV? There is some kind of game here. They go through. No, it's triangle. So you go through the telly. And then you press the phone. then things happen. It's really fucking weird. Is the physical Red Vox album limited? Yes and no. There's about 120 left in the store. Maybe 100. So yeah, it's limited in that sense. And then, if we order, just say, like, another 200, then that's gonna be expensive. So you wanna buy in a higher quantity, like more in bulk. Which would end up being... like, you know, you'd wanna get 1,000, so you can spend less overall. In any case, there's not enough demand for another 1,000, so that probably wouldn't happen. So, in essence, yeah, it's pretty limited right now, I'd say. What is this? I've been really trying, like, to figure out, like, okay, you know, you get all the little fellas through the TV. You click the phone, they go through the TV, then you go through a different dimension. Got it. I understand. But, yeah, there doesn't really seem to be a whole lot else going on here. Let me do one more. Void ghosts. Do I know what day Red Vox is playing at too many games? I don't. Press M for the map. Oh. Whoops. Okay. I'll just blame that on me being tired. Yes, that's a good excuse. Here, let me just see what the map looks like. Oh, I see. Okay. X, X, X. Okay. Okay, I kind of see what's going on, a little bit. But still not enough to really know what the fuck to do. Yeah, and Jed, there is a delay. There's a 30-second delay. And, you know, sometimes, sometimes I'm not reading the chat because I'm looking at the game. And, or responding to someone else. Okay, let's see. Void ghosts. Here we go. Oh, okay. So many different characters to choose from. I'm gonna go for Greenbird. Following me on Twitter, that's nice. It's an action game. I can't help but think of Enter the Gungeon. Immediately my mind goes to that. Even though there's 1,000 games before Enter the Gungeon that did that exact same thing. So whose past am I killing now? I like the physics of the weapons. Oh my god, minigun. I don't like that I'm killing mushrooms though, I feel really bad. There's 1,000 games like this. I think a lot of these games that I'm playing tonight and that I do play on Sundays are from game jams. Get to the portal. So if they're short and they don't seem like they have a lot of depth to them, it's probably because they were made for a game jam or for a resume. Series of games about the cloning and then going to space. That whole thing, whatever that was, this reminds me of that. Something 12, yeah, it was something or other 12. Alright. Well, it's cool, but... Alright, that was Void Ghosts, and I think that'll be it. I'm gonna check the art now, and get going. We're still not fully through the Lizard Crate. Also, Alizarin made a thread. On the forum, Experiment 12 was the name of it, thank you. Yeah, Alizarin made a thread in the forum, so if you want to download any of those games or learn about them a little bit, you can check out that thread, and all of them are there, I think. So, I mean, if you want to post the link in the chat, that would be great. But yeah, that was pretty cool. There's still more games in the Lizard Crate that we can get to. Before everyone goes, before I do the art, I will say that you should definitely check out the other streamers on vinesauce.com or twitch.tv/team/vinesauce. Just give them a follow, check out their streams. If I'm not streaming and you're interested in watching someone else, honestly, even if I am streaming and you want to watch another streamer, you could just watch me later on Full Sauce. I don't mind. But I do appreciate you guys coming to the stream tonight. And also, Wednesday will be the anniversary stream. It's our 6-year anniversary of existing. That is the Vinesauce stream. And the day after is my birthday. So kind of be doing a 2-in-1 stream. I think corruptions are going to be happening that day. Maybe some more weird stuff, but also some stuff I've done in the past. So I'll try to make like a variety stream out of it. And I think it should be cool. But that's Wednesday. Okay. That's it. Also, Too Many Games is a convention I'm going to. And if you are in any way, shape, or form interested, it's a really good convention. It's June 24th? Yeah, I think it's June 24th. I think my band is going to be playing there, as well as a number of other people. There's going to be a lot of people there. So, it should be cool. I think you guys will enjoy it if you go, and yeah, that's it. So just type Too Many Games in Google.